let's practice our windshield wipers. Is everybody synchronized swimming? Feeling good?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Let me try this angle. Okay, so let's just go ahead, open up to a wide straddle T. Good. So we're going to keep nice engagement through the legs. You can even micro bend the knees here. Can you feel that? But keep your hips dropped. See if you can isolate those two parts of the body. Bend the right knee in. Grab for the leg loop. Drop the hips. So engage, but relax. Can you find more relaxation in the hips and more engagement through the upper body? So the upper body feels like it can, the lower body can feel supported and dropping. Okay, good. So there's a couple different stretches we can do here. The right hand can grab the right knee and pull it towards the body. Right hand, right knee. So I'm pulling in strongly. I'm allowing there to be more space for the hips to drop. If I push the hips down, then you get a deeper stretch to your glutes. So the second one is actually letting the knee drop, spiraling the energy towards the earth. So the foot is coming up and in. Left hip is okay if it rises as well. And keep pointing the right knee down. An amazing stretch. Okay? Slowly release. Open it up. So what is this called? What position is this?
Wide straddle T.
Star.
Starfish.
Star. Starfish, yes.
Starfish
or starfish. Drop your hips a little more.
Oh, wide straddle T. You're up.
So drop your hips a little bit more in star, Heather. There it is. All right, come back to the wide straddle T. Bend the left knee in. Really good, guys. Go ahead and stretch into a floating pigeon, so drop the hips. So we can hold on to the leg loop strongly, we can pull on the foot, we can grab the knee. Lots of different variations. See if you can drop the hips a little bit more, the foot comes up.
Ooh.
No?
Well, something just moved in my mind.
So it comes up like this, like rock the baby in yoga.
My hips are really...
Yeah, you're like, no, there's no baby. Funny to have you guys next to one another. She's all like really high leg loops. It's okay to bring the leg loops down a little bit more to make it easier or bring them up to make them harder, but that's kind of how it works. Go ahead and push the knee down towards the ground. So at the same time, pulling the foot in and spiraling. So get that spiral in the leg. This is a real tough one for people, but notice what happens in the back body. I call this the money pose. So money. So good. And it's a big stretch. So if we get the foot spiraling in and the knee spiraling down, we can transition into the side tree. Right hand has to reach up high. No, no, no. Get your anchor. Yep, yep. See? This is a real common thing that people want to do, but this is a much safer position because if we happen to do a flip from here, we really want to use our anchor. So even though we're getting into a lot of detail, so, Julia, that looks great. You just lost your anchor, though, so that's the swing. So here. No, no, no. Keep your arm wrapped around. Hug around the swing. Reach forward towards me and grab the leg loop. Yes, there it is. It's easy to lose that line. That's why I said it's tricky. Foot is going to find the inner thigh if it can reach. Beautiful. That's lovely. And see how different it feels? The other way was okay, but this is a little bit more engaged. All right, so flying ninja, extend from the fingertips to the toes, one long line of energy. So see if the hand can go right in line. Release, come back through the wide straddle T, chillax in arms, wide windshield wipers.
You know, you put those phone numbers on a business screen. Think about it, right?
Most therapeutic practices are going to become obsolete with the swing. It's amazing.
Right.
Okie dokie. So we have a second side. We come through neutral. We bend the right knee in. Nice and gentle and slow. Keep your arms wide to hug and wrap around. So, Julia, come back. Hug. Wrap. It's really easy and common.
Outside in, I gotta remember.
Outside in, it's a hug, right. So go ahead and find the foot on the bottom. We have to reach up really high on our leg loop. Reach a little bit higher, Deborah, so you can pull. There you go.
Perfect. Expand and extend.
Beautiful, guys.
Look amazing.
Mm-hmm. Flying ninja, nice long line of energy from fingertips to toes. Exactly. Go ahead and bring it down, neutralize nice and slow. Just feel the difference. Just feel the difference in the hips and in the body. I try to make these hip openers as fun as possible because it's intense for people, right? You can feel like, ah. That would be the sound the hips are making. Ah. All right, so from there we come into our swing bada. So from swing bada, does anybody remember which pose we do next? What's the name of it?
Pigeon? No.
So, what's it called?
We just did pigeon.
Flying monkey.
Flying monkey.
Okay, so Bob, I need you to reach forward for the leg loops.
Okay.
So a nice way to remember is come and touch your shins, and then reach up. There we go. I'm always learning how to get people to get the leg loops instead of the swing, so it's good. So we don't come all the way up. We press the hips up and lean back. Flying monkey.
Oh, yeah.
And this is what again, monkey, right?
Flying monkey.
Flying monkey.
Flying monkey. Okay.
From here, let's go ahead and do a bicep curl and sit on our feet. So we have to reach up as high as we can so we have the room to do the bicep curl. So our hands are by our shoulders. Then go ahead and exhale, lower back down. Just leave the hips up. The upper body is going to arch and open. Inhale, bicep curl. So it's a good way to build upper body strength in order to do some of the flips, right?
But we have to learn, like rock climbing, to press our
hips up towards the wall in order to be able to lift our body. Our hips are sinking back. We're not able to pull forward. Those that do acrobatics, can you understand what I mean?
Yes.
Okay. So we sink our hips down. We keep holding on. Open up the legs. Wide straddle. Bicep curls. These ones are hard. Only do a couple because people will make really weird faces at you. Don't let go. You need to shake out the hands for a second. It's okay. So we're like, wah. Go ahead and thread. So this is for the W. So we're going to hold on strongly. We can pull one side towards us. That's great. Yep. Just thread through. Try it again. It's okay. Yep. Grab for that one and then pull. So see what? Yep, you had it.
I did?
Yeah, just try it again. And then turn your fingers over. And now pull. It's okay.
So if we didn't thread, we would slide up our legs, which is no big deal. So inverted W is when your feet point towards the sky and then you arch.
If your feet are pointing towards me, it's no big deal. It's just a different pose. So, Kyra, can you look back and see Amy and see how different she is in the pose?
And me?
Yeah. No, Amy, you're good. I'm just encouraging Kyra to keep leaning back and pulling, so I'm just going to help you get that last little bit. So, So it's the difference between like the inverted W and the wow, it's just that extra little bit. Yeah, so you're pulling down strongly with the hands and then you're arching. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, Amy.
That's so
good.
The pants, it's all about the pants. We love Amy.
It's just the pants.
Oh my gosh.
Maybe I need to buy pants like that to look like that, right?
That's all it takes.
It's all in the pants, yeah.
All right, guys. So that was good. We went through the whole sequence. We can have a little break now. Does anybody want to go through anything else while we're here? Any questions?
So the monkeys are...
That is wow.
Wow.
What is wow? Wow. Which one was wow?
The inverted W.
Oh, the one... Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The big W.
Yeah, so this is,
wait, let me see. This is inverted W.
Uh-huh.
This is wow.
So when your hips stack over your shoulders.
Yes.
That's inverted. Okay. So most people are just going to go into the inverted W. Right.
I can, like, not do it now at this point. And then you just pull and come straight up and down.
See, Kara, oh, there's a lot of tension on my arms the whole time. So you were bringing your legs up, but the arms got soft, so you just kind of pull the whole thing. Good.
You really can't cheat on this, can you?
It really is true serum.
So awesome.
Beautiful, guys. So that was all of number three. We'll go through the one-legged poses tomorrow and in the workshop today a little bit if we...